You know, one of my favorite sounds is screeching brakes on a railroad car. And boy, across the way, there are thousands of them. It, of course, is the historic Conway Yards. At one time, the largest push-button rail yard in the country. And it's now the home of someone that I'm a big fan of, Norfolk Southern. And long before then, the Pennsylvania Railroad and Conrail. Single-handedly has employed tens of thousands of people throughout this region. But none more than right here in Freedom, Pennsylvania. This is a town that has really shown me a lot of grit through the years. You know, back in the 60s, their main street was actually taken away because of the expansion of Route 65. And as of the last census, just a little over 1,500 people still live here. This food court is underway with food trucks tonight. And of course, Brewster's old-fashioned ice cream, Normeely and Mario Leone, out of Hopewell. I love when they get out and support each other, these communities, but it gives me a chance to talk about what I believe will keep communities like this vibrant for decades to come. Manufacturing, and many people here have worked in the coal industry and the steel industry, along with that great railroad. And you know, you have the best of both worlds. You have the downtown, and just a few miles up the hill, you have agriculture and great farms in New Swickley Township. So it truly is a slice of heaven, Freedom, Pennsylvania. But tonight, Rob Pratt Tuesday night takes a close look at jobs, working class, middle class jobs in the manufacturing sector. And yeah, the Shell Petrochemical plant is giving us a lot of hope, but we have to continue to help those in the steel industry and beyond. Two great guests, especially heading towards the midterm elections, and why you need to focus on which candidate is going to continue to create jobs. We'll be joined by Jim Roddy and Terry Madonna, all tonight on KDK Radio. Good evening.